side is this, it's just overall investment in the Sheffield community and being fully all in on supporting all aspects of the community. Even if you're an athlete, you support students who are in band or other activities. If you're a part of those activities or just a part of the student body, you support the athletes because you recognize that we're all one Charger community.
I'm going to give you an example of two things that happened in our state championship game that makes me very emotional. But you know, when Drew Roman scored his touchdown, there was a kid who was kind of buried under a little pile that's happened from Erie, and you know, Joe Walker, who's a kid, you know, he's had his ups and downs here, but to me, that's Charger pride. Like, he, you know, one of the biggest moments in all of our sports career, and his first thought was to help the kid up. To me, that was awesome. And then after the game, when the final Hail Mary dropped to the ground, everyone's rushing the field, and you see number 10, Caden Logan. First thing he does is find that quarterback, and he kneels down to him and puts his arm around him. To me, that exhibits Charger pride. Is that we have people and young men in our football program who know what it's about, know that it's not just about us, and that Charger pride extends to other people and other schools. And so those were two moments that really stood out to me after that game, that just after I saw those, I was like, that's awesome. So.
You know, I think there are so many moments that are in my head, and there's so many amazing students at the school. But when I was standing in the end zone for the last touchdown, and I watched the two football players purposely grab the other player, pick him up, tap him on the back of the head, and say whatever they said to him, it made me so proud to be a Charger, because that is, like, they didn't even remember they were being filmed. They did it because it's really who they are, and I think that comes from our atmosphere here at school, as well as it comes from the coach and his expectations of his players. And that, to me, was Charger pride. I believe that students who are involved in one sport but go to another sport, or go to a theater, or go to a band concert, that's Charger pride. When our theater students went to watch Columbine's theater production of the same play that we did this year, Clue, that to me was Charger pride, because it's like, we want to support our whole community. It's not just Chatfield, it's outside these walls too.
The naming after Mrs. Gunkel was my idea to name it after her, because I know how much she represents Chatfield, and a lot of people don't know this, but like she's been a big part of my life since I was a little kid. She babysat me when I was a kid. My dad coached her when she was in middle school. She coached her in volleyball. But I don't know if Charger pride is what it is without Mrs. Gunkel. And whenever she retires, and hopefully she never does, there's somebody else that will carry on the torch for what she does. But I just thought it'd be cool. My dad told me about when he went to his last state championship in 1999, they ran a play in front of the whole student body that they thought would be pretty cool. And I was like, yeah, let's do that. And they're like, no, we name plays after celebrities. And in our community, Mrs. Gunkel is a celebrity. She is the heartbeat of our school for sure.
That was a total surprise, like one of the best surprises of my entire life. I went home and I said to my husband, like, why me? Because to me, the football team has so much going for them. The fact that they even ever thought of me and to do that for me is something that it hits deep, and I am super thankful, and I don't take it lightly.
She's like the heart of Chatfield. She does so much for us and just never asks for anything back, really, or anything like that. She's just so humble about everything that she does, and that's taught me a lot about just being a leader.
Mm-hmm. I think Coach Wigat for me. I mean, you're close to him too, but as I've gone throughout school, I think being a Charger is more about just like winning and being a good student. It's more about being a good person. And I think he's someone who like has humility and integrity, and you never hear him gloat or anything, and he's definitely made the biggest impact on me at Chatfield.
I really believe that we were down 24-7. You know, the team, finally took ownership of the team. Until then, I think they were so reliant on coaching that at that point, I was like, well, we're done. And they took over. Like, it was like, they were going to figure out a way. And it seemed the same way in Pine Creek. And so when you have a team do that, it's so powerful. And so that's what's crazy. You never know what makes a championship team, and this team figured it out.
During the phases, we've been down a lot, and we persevered in the face of adversity. Got the job done.
Yeah. And what showed to me is that I know that every one of those stands at Mile High this last week, I know that those guys were not all football fans, but we all came together for this moment to celebrate each other, and it was really cool. And you know, for me, it was cool when Drew Roman scored the touchdown, and I like ran out in the field, but I turned around and I just started staring at our fans to see everybody so happy.
Being in that student section for the football games was like insane.
Unreal. We knew, me and Drew knew we had a chance to make a play, and as soon as we knew we made it, it was unreal seeing the crowd erupt. Going to the sideline, hearing the chants, we won, it was surreal. Well, I know Drew's got great height on him, great hands, great route running. It'll be a big threat in the future.
Yeah, I know Jake's probably one of the best players, just in general, that I've ever played with. He always gets me the ball like on time, good throws, and he's just a great player, and he'll be good for a long time.
My family, chatting for like the rest of my life, and I feel like I will be part of this school, and this school will be part of me.